Everyone probably has done it at least once in their sim racing career. A pit stop. While they are mostly used to repair damage, or because there is a mandatory pit stop, advanced players can get the most out of them by choosing just the right moment to come into the pits. Another crucial factor is the area where you come out of the pits again. And since no pit is the same length as another, one must know how much time will be lost during a pit stop on every track. So, in order to nail your timing for your next pit stop, you need to be able to A. get a feeling for when your tires are dropping off, and B. have an idea of how long your pit stop duration will be. The first thing regarding pit strategies and tire degradation will be covered in another video. But here and now, we are going to measure how much time you will lose when absorbing a pit stop on every single track in ACC. For your ideal pit stop, you obviously want to lose as little time as possible. This begins at the pit lane entry and ends when the pit limiter is deactivated again. And in order to achieve this, the first thing you want to do is to brake as late as possible for the pit lane entry. In our experiment, we are assuming perfect braking. So the pit lane durations might be a little off depending on your individual braking skills. So we are entering the pits with the pit limiter engaged, and the entry time will be taken as soon as the first pit of our car is above the entry line, which is indicated by the dashboard on our wheel turning green. The same goes for the exit. The time will be taken as soon as our front is above the pit exit line, which is indicated by the dashboard on our wheel going back to normal. This should give us a fairly accurate timing. On the other hand, we will also investigate how long a tire change and the refueling will take. For this, two pit stops are done. One, where only the tires will be changed, and in the other pit stop, we will put about 10 liters of gas into our car. If we know the time it takes to fuel 10 liters, we can easily calculate how long any amount is going to take, since the fuel flow is linear, and the time it takes to lift our car and let it back down will always be the same. First of all, let us determine how long a tire change takes in ACC. The measurements will be a little different from last time, where we used the in-game timer. Instead, I am going by the amount of frames this video footage has and analyze it in my video editor. The first frame that will be counted is the one where our clock inside the car displays 0.0 kilometers per hour. The last frame, on the other hand, is a little trickier to get, since the clock interestingly also displays vertical momentum, so the velocity displayed will be 0 km per hour, then about 5 km per hour when our pit crew lets us back down, and 0 km per hour at the end when we reach the ground, and as soon as this number goes up by 0.1 km per hour, the last legit frame is determined. This leaves us with a tire change duration of only 5.43 seconds. As a comparison for our value, we are going to take a closer look at the pit stops observed in the DTM. There, a normal pit stop takes about 6 seconds, so the pit crew in ACC is quite fast. Almost Red Bull fast, so to say. Secondly, let's figure out how long it takes to put about 10 liters of fuel into our car. This was a bit trickier to figure out than the duration of the tire change, due to one having to kill the engine before any fuel can be added into the car. So this time, the first frame that will be counted is the one where the RPMs begin to drop. On the other hand, the last countable frame will be the one where the car's clock displays 0 km per hour. This leaves us with a time of 7.47 seconds for about 10 liters of fuel, or 3.73 seconds for 5 liters of fuel. Now that we are done with the refueling and tire change timings, let's finally move on to a visualization of the different time losses for each individual pit lane. So, every pit lane is measured in seconds to make it easier if you want to calculate your pit stop times by adding the amount of tire change or whatever. And as you can see, the longest pit lane by far is obviously Paul Ricard, because no one likes the track, please remove it, thanks. Just kidding, it obviously is Spa. With that said, I hope you enjoyed the video and are now able to make better decisions in planning your pit stops. If you did and want to see more sim racing content, you can consider subscribing to this channel. Cheers!